Aren't you getting tired of seeing this graphic? Well, this is for tomorrow, for Friday. Again, the Storm Prediction Center has us in a slight risk for storms to become strong or severe, with the primary threat being a damaging winds. That's pretty much the scenario we see during the summertime. Everything is wind driven, and it's only an isolated tornado threat. As we've seen the past couple of days, wind damage would be the primary threat and a fairly low threat for hail, but still in there. A few places even picked up some pea-sized, marble-sized hail earlier today with some storms out towards the lakes area. So keep this in mind. We want to stay weather aware tomorrow. Have a way to get alerts if you're getting an early start to the weekend and headed out to the lakes. You can see here, as we look at it hour by hour through 7 o'clock tonight, still keeping a little dry time, although still also hanging on to some of those clouds. And from time to time, you could see a few scattered showers by 4 a.m. drift across southern Illinois into the Pennyroyal region. Hopefully this does not materialize, so we continue with that dry weather into the morning hours. But notice by 7 a.m. some clouds arriving from the west in advance of our cold front that's going to be sweeping into the area. I think our highest rain chances will start to develop across Missouri down through Tennessee. But by 11 a.m. you can see a few isolated showers as we get the heat of the day going, some breaks in the cloud cover, some sunshine. That's going to start to bubble up some of those storms. But as we head into the afternoon, the true heat of the day, you can see by 3 o'clock, storm development here in Missouri over towards Tennessee and the Kentucky line, and that will spread a little bit further to the east and southeast by 6 o'clock in the evening. So our Friday evening plans are going to have to include the umbrella and an eye to the sky. And then once we lose the heat of the day, we should see a lot of these showers and thunderstorms start to wind down too.
Little did they know they were moving into the path of one of the country's deadliest tornadoes. Listen as he describes the tornado hitting their home as they took shelter in the basement.
It was actually taking the boards off the flooring above us as it was coming across. The sides of the house blew out, and there was such an updraft coming through there that I was holding a stanchion column, a brick column, foundation column with one arm, and holding my wife down with the other.
And when they emerged, this is what they saw. You can see some of the pictures that he took once they emerged from the basement. Their house, of course, gone, and almost the entire neighborhood gone as well. In fact, he went on to tell me that they never found their 500-pound gun safe that had been carried away from the tornado. It was loaded with guns. They never found that. And they had to go 4 blocks to retrieve their daughter's car from the top of a tree.
Now's the time to just shelter in place. Get to an interior room, lowest level of your home, or get into a low-lying ditch if you have to, if you are in the path of this storm. Again, storm spotters and the National Weather Service, as well as emergency management, have confirmed damage with a tornado on the ground that has just moved through the greater Mayfield area, is now to the east side of town. You're probably not going to see this storm coming if you live directly out ahead of it. We've got a lot of heavy rain. Here's one view from Justin and Tammy Hodge. You can see that tornado there, the condensation funnel, as it reaches down to the ground.
Meteorologist Jennifer Rukavina is in Breckenridge, Colorado for the Weather and Climate Summit. She joins us live tonight. Jen, how can new technology give us more time when warnings are issued?
Well, isn't that the most important thing, having time to prepare when a warning is issued? Well, scientists are always trying to find ways to give us more lead time so that we can prepare. And I want to bring in Lance. He's the director of the National Severe Storms Laboratory, and his group is doing a lot of research on how we can evolve and look at the future of warnings as it relates to tornadoes, severe thunderstorms, lightning, hail, you name it. Tell us a little bit about it.
Well, what we're trying to do with this new program is to redesign the warning system such that information gets to people where they live in a timely fashion, like every neighborhood getting a bit of information updated every 2 minutes, so you can get it on cell phones and on television and really keep people apprised of what's happening.
And if we could show the graphic here that I had sent back for everyone to see, this is kind of an example of how a tornado warning would be issued. Of course, we look at polygons, you being in the polygon of that storm, those 4 points, but also now the probability of you being in the path of it.
And Jennifer, how much rain have we gotten?
Well, it's kind of staggering how much rain we've actually seen in just the past couple of days. While our highest totals have been across southern Illinois and Kentucky, you can see those high totals stretch from Pope County all the way up through Johnson County and even into the Marion, Illinois area. But as we look a little bit further to the southeast, it's really been western Kentucky taking the brunt of the heaviest rain over the last couple of days. You can see here where we're in some of these white areas, we're upwards of 10 inches. More specifically, though, as we look at the list from the Kentucky Mesonet, so where they're measuring these rainfall totals in Marshall County, Draffenville coming in at 13.21 inches, all the way down to a 9.11 in Princeton. You can see the Lakes area and the Pennyroyal region really seeing a lot of rainfall over the last couple of days, and we're not done just yet. We do have additional storm chances tomorrow and for the weekend. The good news, those chances start to go down, but we'll track it hour by hour.
Vanderbilt. All right, now time for your weekend football forecast.
That's gracious.
Well, first, Cleveland Brown Santa has joined us to
Does
tell you.
Does he have a broken leg, too?
Like I don't know who else? Is starting for the Browns this weekend.
Santa might as well.
But Vegas has now said 1,000-1 are the odds of them winning the Super Bowl. The Eagles, 35-1.
Save your money,
35-1. Here's your forecast for tomorrow. As SEMO comes to Murray State, game time 6 o'clock, 85 degrees. Don't worry, sun will go down quickly, and it'll be a lot more comfortable out in the stadium than if you are headed to Lexington. God bless you. That game, South Carolina at Kentucky, 83 degrees, 6:30 Central game time with partly cloudy skies.